Okay, anyway, let me start my lesson. Inshallah, we'll go to I'm ready. This guy, man, he has really ambushed me. But anyway, I'm ever ready for the war. So, good morning, boys and girls. You see, this is my mask. I'm just from home. And I'm going to handle an English lesson with you, grade 4. Today, I want us to look at writing a guided composition. And when you talk about guided composition, you are talking about a story that you need to write some points to guide in order to write a good story. So today, whenever you look at page 14 in your composition books, or rather in your booklets, I've drafted some story about my pet. I've drafted some notes for you, for it to guide me in writing that particular story. Now, in that particular story, there's a small animal that I've drawn there. That particular animal is the one that has guided me to draft those points and write a story. So whenever you're writing a story, we have things that you need to consider. One, first of all, let me define the word guide. From the word guide, we get guided. So a guide means to be given a way to go or to be shown a way. So whenever you're being told to write a guided composition, you're basically referring to a story that's being guided following certain criteria or certain points that you'd write by yourself. So today I want us to look at how we are going to do our work. Now, points that you need to remember when you are doing a guided composition. Remember, I want you to open your booklets on page 14. Follow the story with me, because I'm not going to read it, but instead I want you to follow the things that I'm going to talk about. One thing that you need to consider is your handwriting. Whenever you are writing a story, ensure that you are shaping the letters properly and your handwriting is superb. When I talk of a superb handwriting, I mean you are writing, you are shaping the letters well, you are spacing very well, you are paragraphing your work the way I've done mine in that particular booklet on page 14. So take a look at that particular booklet, you see how the letters have been shaped, you see how I've paragraphed my letters, my words, and also look at how the storyline is following or flowing. Because I've tried to follow the points that I've just written there, 1 to 5 points. And from the first paragraph, I was able to draft the first point. So that's how we go about it. Now, the other thing that you need to consider whenever you are writing a guided composition, boys and girls, it's we need to insert some humor in it. And when we talk of humor, we are referring to the things that you love to use or the words that you're going to use in order to make your composition a very interesting one, as well as how can I say, making the reader to laugh. So whenever you do that, you'll be able to generate a lot of enthusiasm to that particular reader, and the reader will be smiling while reading a story. The other thing that you need to consider whenever you're writing a story, you need to include figurative expressions. When you talk of figurative expressions, we are referring to items, or rather words, that we use, the English expressions that we use to make your story have a lot of humor. One of the figurative expressions that we have are the proverbs. You can say, my mother is as fast as a deer. Now, that mother of yours means she always runs very fast or walks very fast. That's why she's very fast. Another example of a figurative expression that we have exaggeration. An exaggeration is whereby you add some more salt to that particular thing that you're talking about. For example, you can say, my mother or my grandmother is so old that his skin or her skin has shrunk, that you can be able to detach it with a needle. So you see, such things, that shows, it brings the picture to the reader, how old that grandmother of yours is. The other figurative expression that you can also use, we have the similes. I've talked of the similes. That's as fast as a deer, or as brave as a lion, and so on. The other thing, you can also use a metaphor. A metaphor is an English expression that compares two things that are unlike. For example, you can say, my mother or my father is a lion. Your father indeed is not a lion, but you're trying to compare your father and a lion. Now look at those two things. Then that shows that your father is very brave or courageous or even harsh, because whenever you look at the characteristics of a lion and compare to your dad, they almost resemble. But you don't say your dad is a lion. You can also say that lady has a heart of stone. There's nobody who has a stone heart. But instead, when you talk of heart of a stone, then it means that that particular person is cruel or unkind. He can do some funny things or unkind things to you. They are not good people. So those are some of the English expressions that you need to include in your story. Even proverbs are still English expressions that you need to include in your story. For example, you can say, clutches at a straw. A drowning man clutches at a straw. That means whenever you are drowning, you want to catch anything for you to save yourself, be it a grass or anything. You are trying to fumble in order to get saved by something. So those are the kind of English expressions that you can also use. So I want you to look at that particular story, read it, write it down in your books, ensure that your handwriting is nice, copy the story the way it is, and try and write a very good handwriting as possible, and give your mama or your dad the work to mark it for you. So thank you so much for watching. Have a blessed day. Goodbye.